You're telling us a little bit about the competition, but now things are starting to get a little bit more tight in terms of deadlines, because we've got the first real deadline looming for the synopsis, which needs to be submitted on the 15th of January. But before all that, can we just talk about what the competition entails? Who'd be the best person to talk about this? I suppose maybe a competitor, first of all. From your side of things, what is the competition?
Basically, for me, it was just a huge opportunity. I've been going to the Litfest for 6 years, and I heard, I think via email, that it was the first year of the competition in 2013. And so when I heard about it, I had my kind of synopsis written already, I had my story created, and so I just put them in and just saw what happened.
Charles, who is from Montegrappa. Montegrappa has sponsored this event. It's the first fishing competition. Why has Montegrappa got involved?
Well, as a manufacturer of fine writing instruments and luxury products, it's not enough just to make these fancy things. We also have to be involved in the world that uses them. And the world of writing, of course, is very important to us. Despite the fact that nowadays most people write into a keyboard and a computer, we still know that this all comes from the art of handwriting initially, and then gets into the page in one form or another. But we wanted to be involved in these sorts of activities. The Emirates Airline Festival of Literature has been a fantastic vehicle for us to partner with over the last years. We actually got involved initially 5 years ago for the first time with a children's writing competition. Mm-hmm. And then the first fiction competition started only in 2013. So this is the third year that will be going this year. But we've been involved with the festival since for 5 years now. So
it has an incredible track record, doesn't it, the adult one, just from my year alone. Obviously my book's out and I've got another book on the way, and then I came second, and the winner also has a publishing deal, and her book will come out, Annabelle Cantaria, her book comes out in May. And I don't think there can be many competitions like this where you have quite such a high sort of hit rate.
It's absolutely amazing what's happened here, and again, large credit to the Festival of Literature itself. But it's really incredible that we've had such a good result. We've also done this in conjunction with a literary agent in the UK, Luigi Bonomi, who has helped some of these winners and runners-up to take their work further. We've also done another writing competition in the UK, which was on a much bigger scale, actually. We did that with The Independent and with Scholastic Books and with the Luigi Bonomi Associates, and that had more than 1,000 entries because it was publicized as a UK-wide competition. But so far, we've had a winner who is yet to be published. But what's amazing is with the far smaller catchment area, say, that we have here, and the smaller number of entries that we had in the UAE competition, the fact that we've had now, I think it's safe to say three, I mean, one already published, one soon to be published, and one very likely to be published in just 2 years of writing competition. So that's a great achievement for us, for the festival, and of course
it's also a massive opportunity for anyone who's sort of sitting there listening, who's got their manuscript tucked away in the drawer. Mm. Because I just put my, it was already written. There are so many people I think in Dubai, from talking to them and in Abu Dhabi and around the Emirates, who have written books and possibly have even written their submission letter, their synopsis, but are just sitting on them and don't know what to do with them. And that's the position I was in, which is why it was such a great opportunity to be able to send them off. And then look what happened.
And it's a terrific success rate. So let's explain then how it works. As mentioned at the start, the deadline is looming. January the 15th is the all-important date. So what do people need to do between now and January the 15th?
The entry is to submit a synopsis, and I believe a first chapter. Is that the...
Yes. As far as I understand, it's 1,000 words. But
right. So you have to submit that. You can submit it on the Emirates Airline Festival of Literature Montegrappa First Fiction Writing Competition webpage, which is a bit of a mouthful, but it's not so complicated once you go to the Emirates Litfest .com website. It's quite easy to find under there. And the instructions to enter are all there. And essentially, yes, you have to submit your work. in a fairly limited form. It's not the barrier to entry is not that high. You don't have to write the entire novel. The UK competition that we did, you have to submit an entire novel.
Wow.
And we still got more than 1,000 entries, which was remarkable considering the barrier to entry is so high. So it's not so hard here. I would encourage people who, even if you haven't already got a manuscript written in the drawer that you've been shy to show anyone, even if you've not reached that stage, but you have something, some output that you know you'd like to get out, it's quite realizable. And
that's very true. The winners for the last 2 years, neither of them had completely written the book. So it's possible to enter, like you say, early stages with the idea in your head.
Yeah. What's fantastic as well is that the people we work with, the LBA books from the UK, and Luigi Bonomi himself is very keen to help develop the writers and the authors. So what's wonderful about this competition is that you don't have to have submitted an entire manuscript. You can come with your synopsis and the basic requirements for entry, and then you will get additional guidance along the way to help you get to a stage.
Yeah, he's been fantastic.
Exactly.
Because he's now my literary agent. So what happened was, after I got the placing in the competition, he then took the book away, looked at it, and within a month of that competition second place, I had the two-book deal. So there really, you know, really is a good opportunity for people.
I'm talking to Rachel Hamilton, who was a runner-up in the first fiction competition by Montegrappa in 2013 and subsequently got a book deal from that, and Charles Nahhas, the Montegrappa distributor for the Middle East. We're talking about the first fiction competition by Montegrappa, which is, well, the first deadline is looming, in fact. January the 15th, you need to get a synopsis if you are interested in taking part. This is then read and judged by a committee headed by a top UK literary agent, Luigi Bonomi, and the winner will receive a fairly significant prize here. We've got a lunch meeting with Luigi Bonomi, a trip to the London Book Fair 2015, and most importantly, an open, or at least a jar door, to the world of publishing. This is all part of the Emirates Airline Festival of Literature. Competition is sponsored by Montegrappa and Charles Nahhas, the Montegrappa distributor for the Middle East, and Rachel Hamilton, runner-up from the very first fiction competition in 2013, who received a two-book deal with Simon & Schuster based on her competition entry, The Case of the Exploding Loo,
yes,
which says is a book for children aged 10 to 13, but I'm sure it's enjoyed by all age groups.
I wrote it for me, and I'm way outside that
and
age
I read
bracket.
It,
and you liked
and
it.
I thought it was excellent. I read it to my children, but I think I enjoyed it possibly more than they did. But that's maybe a reflection on me rather than them.
So just to be clear, with this date of January the 15th, you don't have to submit an entire novel by then. A synopsis and the first, I think it's 1,000 to 2,000 words, we can check that online. As long as you've got that in, that means you are in the competition.
Yes.
And then you have, then you're guided to help finish off your novel from then on.
Exactly. And the spoils are significant, let's say, because you can, this is genuinely and realistically, we've demonstrated it now more than once, that this is a way that you can actually become a published author. And as well as the opportunities to meet the publishing agents and to go to London, to the London Book Fair, you also get a very beautiful Montegrappa writing instrument, which you didn't mention.
I love my beautiful Montegrappa writing instrument.
I'm sorry about that. It wasn't in my list.
Oh, okay.
Maybe you were too shy to write it down as your PR people. I don't know. Let's do some tips, shall we? What would you suggest for people that might be interested in taking part? What would you suggest they should start thinking about, or any tips about how they approach the finishing off their novel if they're maybe halfway through?
This is one for Luigi, I feel. he normally comes and gives a very good explanation of what, you know, aspiring authors should be doing, what he would be looking for as an agent. But maybe, Rachel, you're the best person to answer this.
What he always says to me, because he's obviously my agent now with the books, is what he's looking for is a clear voice. So even from such a short kind of submission, so 1,000, 2,000 words, he believes you can get the voice from the first few words. And if it's authentic and original, then that already interests him. He's looking for something that is a bit different, but still close enough to be able to be sold, if you see what I mean.
Yes.
So you can be original, but if you're too original, then maybe it might be a bit out there. So it's worth, he's agents split into different camps, and he's quite a business-like agent. And so what he's looking for is something that will sell and that publishers will be interested mm-hmm. in. So it's probably worth people looking at the genre they're interested in and reading within that genre or finding out what works and what doesn't. So because I knew I was writing for kids and I knew I was looking at that kind of 9 to 12 age range, I would read a lot of the books that were popular in that group. So David Walliams, for example, and people like that. Similarly, if somebody's writing a thriller, there's obviously all sorts of fantastic ones out there that they can look at. And other than that, I think it's just write what makes you happy, because if you're going to be writing for the rest of your life, then that's what you want to be doing.
Of course, you've got to enjoy what you're doing, don't you? That's yeah. fundamental to anything. And I take it you wouldn't enter a competition if you're not hoping to become a published author at the end of the day.
I would think so, yeah.
And so all this takes place over the next few months. When does it all get resolved?
During the festival itself.
And yeah, so the festival
you don't
dates.
Know when you go, which was exciting. So yes. we were sat there just waiting for the announcement. So I don't know what day. Do you know what day it is on in the festival?
It's on yet? The... I believe it's on the Thursday afternoon at the festival, so which I don't have my calendar right now, but it's maybe the 7th of March is the day of the actual announcement. It'll be one of those days, I think the Thursday of the festival.
And so everybody who's entered will be invited to attend. And then you sit there nervously and wait for the results to be read out. And Luigi does his little talk about what's important in publishing and how he's found the results. And then off he goes. And it's a very exciting moment if you're one of the winners or runners-up.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much for coming in today to tell us all about it. So basically, you have, it works out just under 6 weeks if you are interested in getting involved in the first fiction competition by Montegrappa. For full details, go on to the Emirates Airline Festival of Literature website. Google that. That'll get you to the website and you'll be able to find out full details of how you can take part and all the details of what happens and the next stages, etc., etc., to the final announcement of the winner in the Emirates Airline Festival of Literature 2015, taking place next March.
So don't spend your Christmas just sitting eating mince pies. get writing.
Mince pies and
get
write.
Writing. There's yes. a lot of time. This is the great time to do it during the little quiet period we'll have between Christmas and New Year. Get writing.
And Charles and Rachel, thank you very much for coming in today.
Thank you.